glory to God. He's not making any, God is not making any distinction in any temple. He's not a respecter of person, but he is a respecter of principle. Catch that. He's not a respecter of person. Anybody can come in and be a part of the family of God. I don't care if you're lesbian or gay. Matter of fact, he wants those in to change them. Y'all got to help me. Amen. Hallelujah. He wants those that are on crack in to change them. He wants those that are on dope in to change them. He wants those that are gangbanging in to change them. He wants those that are going through so much trial and so demonically influenced and so engaged in sin. He wants to come in because he wants to show his glory off. He wants to show what he can do for them. He wants to show how he can turn their mind around, how he can turn their heart around, how he can turn their spirit around. So he's saying, whosoever will, let him come. Hallelujah. Open up the door. Hallelujah. If you're hungry, come on in. I'll feed you. If you're thirsty, come on in. I'll give you something to drink. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. If you get hungry, if you're hungry and thirsty after righteousness, he said, I just won't give you enough to satisfy you. I'll give you enough to fill you up. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. David said, my cup is going to run over. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. That means I'm going to give you abundance. I'm going to give you more than enough. I'm going to give you increase, enough to feed you and your kids. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Then I'll give you a little extra to help the stranger, somebody that's on the corner that don't have as much as you got. I'll put a little extra in your pocket that after all your bills is paid, after everything is met, after your children are taken care of, your church is taken care of, you can go out and help somebody else out without struggle. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God, amen. Yeah, that's what he wants. Glory to God. So he says that I'm not a respected person, but I am a respecter of principle. That I do have some requirements in order for you to be a temple that I want to come back and get. And so now you have, in the city, they have certain ordinances in the city. Before you begin to build, you got to get a license to build. Amen, somebody. You got to get a contract. You got to make sure you're not digging in the wrong spot. You got to make sure there's no underlying hazardous pipelines lying down there before you start digging. So you can't just dig anywhere like you want to. Even if you got a license, you got to be careful where you dig, and you got to go according to the ordinances. You got to have a specific type of contract, and you got to specify what kind of building you want to build. If it's going to be a single family home, or if it's going to be commercial property, amen. If it's going to be a duplex, amen, or a fourplex, or if it's going to be, amen, a strip mall, you got to have certain ordinances that the city requires that you have and meet before you even begin to build. Amen. Praise God. And so you see there's components that go into place even before the house goes up. There's order that has to be established before you can even start laying the foundation. Amen, praise God. And so when you look at Ephesians, check out some of the components and things that he has helped us with. Amen, praise God. It says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Okay, now. All. All spiritual blessings where? In heavenly places. So this shows us another aspect of God. Before he builds the temple, he has the material to build with. Everything that's going to make your temple beautiful, he has the material to make it happen.
Amen.
He has the wood, he has the gold, he has the silver. Y'all got to help me. Amen. Praise God. He has the stone, he has the bricks, he has the contractors, he has the electrical heat mat. Y'all gotta catch it. Amen, praise God. Every person that's gonna add to you is already in place and willing to help you.
Amen. Yep.
Every person that's gonna add to your building, God has ordained them to help you. Every person that needs to fund your vision that you got from God, if he's giving you a vision, a program, something to do down here on earth, remember, it's not your vision. You just received it and you're on assignment to carry it out. This chair. Y'all got to give God some praise on that one. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'll catch this. Hallelujah. This is bread from heaven, y'all. I'm catching this right now. Amen. Even the materialization of this church was not my vision. I was just chosen as the person to bring it to pass.
Right.
This is not my purpose. The purpose and the drive that I have was put in me by God. He has given me the drive and the purpose to do this. Because He has a destiny for this church. I don't know the complete destiny, but just the things that I get in my mind, I know is great. Just the images that I have and the creative ideas that come, they're not coming from me. I didn't go to school for this. I went to school for math and computers. I didn't go to school to build a church. Y'all got to help me. Amen. Praise God. Church wasn't even on my brain when I was in college. Other stuff was on my brain. But this was on God's mind before I was created. Catch this. He had this proposed locked up in the storehouses of His knowledge and wisdom before I even came into existence, that He don't know it yet, but I'm going to use Him to birth a church out of Him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm going to use her to bring to pass a great organization. I'm going to use Him to build a Fortune 500 company.
Right.
I'm going to use her to travel all over the world and tell people about my glory and my vision.
Yes,
hallelujah. I'm going to give this one a certain kind of skill set so they can build monuments. I'm going to give this one a certain kind of skill set so they can be organized. I'm going to give this one a certain kind of skill set so they can manage money. Amen. I'm going to give them the character to manage money. I'm going to give them the mindset. I'm going to give them the patience. I'm going to give them the wherewithal. I'm going to give them the wisdom. I'm going to give them the ingenuity on how to make money grow, how to form it, how to trade, how to barter, invest and get returns.
Yes.
I'm going to teach them how to do all these things. I'm going to give them the mindset. I'm not going to make them good at philosophy. When it comes to philosophy, they're not going to know anything. But put some numbers down in front of them, they're like the whiz kid.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. Hey, they just know it. It's just easy to them. Don't even got to study. Hallelujah. Just look at a book. I got it. People get envious of you because it comes to you so easy.
Huh.
Like, man, I got to cram and feel like cheating just to get a B or a C. And you just laugh, you just read other books, and you get straight A's all the time like it's no big deal. Why? Because you've been chosen. God, and that's a gift from God. That is a gift from God. He has chosen you. He's trying to tell you what your purpose is in life. He's trying to tell you what kind of temple He has predestined for you to be. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. And so when you find out who you are, you're really not finding out who you are, but you're finding out what God's purpose is for you. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. And through finding out what God's purpose is, you'll find out who you are.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. And then when you find out who you are, you'll look back at the devil and say, who is you?
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. You look at this bomb that's trying to destroy your life, man, why would I waste time with you? When you're trying to tell me one thing, causing me to go into an identity crisis, giving me this false name, giving me this false program, giving me another vision that you got for me, amen, and it's not the vision that God has for me, but I didn't know how, because I was in darkness, I was blind, I couldn't comprehend, amen, I was lost and didn't know it, hallelujah, or couldn't help it, amen, or didn't even care, hallelujah, because there's some people in sin, they know they sinned, but they don't even care that they sin. They wait for Friday to drink, and they know it's wrong. They know it's killing them. They know it's messing up their liver. They know it's destroying their brain. But they'll go do it again. The Bible says they became inflamed with alcohol. Amen. It was on fire in sin. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. And couldn't wait to do it again. Didn't care. Lost and didn't care. Hallelujah. Know it was wrong. Got the hot barbecue bone in your mouth, burning your lips, sizzling your tongue. You know you should take it out, but it tastes too good to take out. Barbecue sauce too good. It just tastes too good. But you know it's burning you, but it tastes good. You know it's killing you, but it tastes good. It's causing blisters all in your mouth, but it tastes good. And a lot of people have that type of, I know that's some kind of analogy. That got to be God, because I didn't think about that one. Amen. Praise God. But there are some people that are in sin. It tastes good to them. It tastes so good, but it's burning them. It's killing them. It's destroying them. But it feels too good for them to stop. So they keep doing it. Knowing it's going to destroy them, but they keep doing it. Knowing crack is going to kill them, but they keep doing it. Knowing that alcohol is going to cause them to be an alcoholic, but they keep doing it. Knowing that smoking is hazardous to your health. I mean, if the Surgeon General said that, come on, y'all. If the Surgeon General, not just a doctor out of high school, and it was from tests that they did, and you can see the results of cancer in people, and not only that, but our bodies automatically produce cancer cells that are destroyed daily through our immune system. And so you're going to add to that automatically. Yeah. Hallelujah, glory to God. And then you will spend $5-6 on a pack. Some people will. $5-6 on a pack of cigarettes. $30-$50 on a carton. Weekly. But can't let go of that cable though. Oh, they gotta have that cable TV. Yep. They keep the cable TV. Hallelujah. They keep the pack of cigarettes. Hallelujah, glory to God. Yep. They'll keep all of that. But when it comes time to support God's work, oh, they'll struggle. When it comes time to give to somebody else, they'll struggle. Oh, boy. Hallelujah. They'll be killing them. The cigarettes will be killing them. They'll still be smoking. They'll be like chain smokers. Breath all bad. Gums turning all black. Y'all got to help me. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Just lungs all jacked up. Amen. Still doing it. 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 years old.
I'll have my cigarette. I have my cigarette and a cup of coffee. Early in the morning.
Before I get going. Have my little drink. Have my little blow. Got to have that before I go to bed so I can ease my mind. Yeah. No, it's killing them. Amen. Gotta have my little two, have my little, you know. Gotta have it before I go to bed, because I can't live without it. Amen. Fooled by the enemy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Not knowing that God, y'all gotta help me. Amen. Not knowing that God has a divine purpose and plan that's way better. Hallelujah. More efficient. Hallelujah. More cleaner. Hallelujah. More prosperous. Hallelujah. More holy. Amen. Before the foundations of the world, he laid the foundation so you can be successful. Let's give God some hand praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God.